This is an often seen shape of a delta loop antenna. The sides are equal in length, and in fact it is a standard loop, so the total sum of all the lengths of the wires is one wavelength. And it can be a square shape, then we call it a cubical quad, or it is round and we call it a loop, and triangle is also a loop, but it's all a full wavelength loop. And depending if you feed it on the top or on the side, it is horizontal polarized or it is vertically polarized. But you can also feed it on the bottom or of course the other side. And it's all the same for all the shapes. So if you have a cubical quad with this shape, then you can feed it on the side for vertical polarization and on the bottom or top for a horizontal polarization. The point is, with this shape and this feed point, we have an impedance of about 110 ohms. So you cannot connect the coax cable directly to it. Therefore, I made the shape a bit different. I made it more like this. And in fact, it is even better for the gain, because this is the current maximum, and we have also here the current maximum. So the distance between the two current maximums is wider, so we have some more gain. We can make this triangle under the roof, for example. Then you have the roof like this. But if you want to have it outside, and you have such A-shaped roof, it is likely more easy to have it like this. Then you can have it on the side. Then you have your house here, your roof, and you can put it on the stick outside of the window. And this is how it looks like. Not too difficult. This is the way I routed the wire. I drilled a hole in a piece of old wood that I had laying around, and I just did the wire through the hole. However, you can also use, of course, a tywrap or a plastic tubing for this or whatever. It is not so critical. In the center of the boom, I made some adjustment that I can screw a stick on it, so I can stick it out of the roof. And that's all. This is the way I connected the connector. This is the loop. And as you can see, I twisted the wire here. That's a bit strange, but by twisting it, you have still the same impedance, because twisted wire, two wires, is about 50 ohm, and it reduces the total length of the delta loop. So by twisting it more or less, I had the idea to lengthen or shorten the total loop length. And it worked. I can adjust the SWR by twisting it. This is the way it sticks out of the window, and when you put it a bit higher, you can see that it can turn by hand, because the shape of the roof combines with the shape of the antenna. For a short demonstration, I have mounted the antenna on a stick, sticked out of the window. This is the bit twisted feed, and this is the coupler with the NWT6000 going to the laptop. And the laptop shows this figure, showing a clear dip, and the frequency, I put a pointer here, is 50.6 MHz. So for most applications with FT8 or SSB, a bit too high. For ATV, more in the direction, but it is a good return loss of minus 25 dB. And I will twist it now more or less. I should twist it less to shift it a bit down. When I do this, a twist less, as you can see. And let's see what happens now on the screen. And as you can see now, I left the pointer at the same position. It is shifted downwards. And if we put the pointer where we wanted to have it, for example 50.25 or so, I can now twist the connector, and what you see is it shifts up. So that's the whole clue. You adjust simple the length of the total one wavelength loop. After adjustment, you just put a simple tape to position the place where they should twist, and that's it. You can likely also cut it off and solder the connector here. Another thing is, this is a balanced feed and the coax cable is unbalanced, so in fact you need a shock here. Just do some turns with your coax cable, or if you are just below your antenna, no problem at all, just connect your transceiver to it. The black line is the radiation pattern of this delta loop, and to compare I have also added the red line, that is the inverted V antenna on the same height. And as you can see, the delta loop has some 1.5 dB more gain, but it has also deeper dips sidewards. So it is, when you rotate the antenna, it is better to notch out stations that you don't want to receive, or QRM. When you look at the vertical and horizontal fields individually, you see that the inverted V antenna has a much more sidewards vertical pattern than the delta loop. This is with horizontal, and this is so the total. So the delta loop has less radiation from and going to the sides of the loop with vertical polarization. Dimensions, of course, this side length is 2.16 meter. That's of course the same as this one, and the upper one, or if you put it reverse way, of course the lower side, but this side has a length of 1.84 meters. So you can make this antenna for the 6 meter band, but you can also make it of course for other bands. If you like this video, please thumbs up or subscribe, and if you have questions, I will read it below and answer it as soon as possible. Enjoy!